Hey, Luxers, isn't it funny that people who often profess to be smarter than average are usually not? But those who fly under the radar, who are not the first to speak, are introverted, quiet individuals, are far smarter than their loud-mouthed, opinionated peers. If you hopped onto this video to affirm that you are indeed smarter than everyone else, chances are you're not. But if you're watching to learn something and see if you feature in any of these traits, you probably are, without even realizing it. Welcome to ALUX.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. If you're not subscribed yet, you're missing out. Number one, you don't need to put much effort into anything you do. If this is you, then you're miles ahead of your peers. If doing something new or retraining your information comes easily to you, then it's a good chance you're smarter than others. Don't despair, ALUXers. If you find yourself struggling to remember things or need to be shown something a dozen times before you're able to do it yourself, you can train your brain to work more efficiently. Our brains need to work out just like our bodies do. First and foremost, stop telling yourself you can't do something. The brain is all powerful, and it'll begin to believe that. Instead, change your rhetoric and never stop learning. Here are a few quick ways to train that lazy brain. Read, listen, rest, keep intelligent company, eat food that's good for the brain, and indulge in brain games like Sudoku, crosswords, Scrabble, and chess. All are fantastic. Number two. You cuss as part of your everyday language. It has been scientifically proven that people who swear are more honest and have higher intelligence. Swearing is a feature of language that articulate speakers use to get the maximum impact out of the message coming across. Swearing has another benefit as well. It offers natural pain relief. A study was conducted which saw several volunteers plunge their hand into ice water. They were told to swear the entire time their hand was in the water. The experiment was repeated, but volunteers were not allowed to swear. Pain tolerance was much better when the participants could vent out their hurt in the form of swear words. We shit you not, ALUXers, so let's carry on with this fucking video, shall we? Number three, you have no problem being in your own company. In fact, those with superior intelligence would rather be in their own company than in the company of others. Most people would just list being with friends as something that brings them happiness, but highly intelligent people don't often have that desire. There are two schools of thinking behind this theory. The first is evolutionary. Smarter people adapt better to the modern world, where we don't need to rely on people for our own shelter, food, or protection. The other is aspirational. When you're smarter, you're driven and focused and don't need the distraction of social interactions. If you love alone time, be sure to watch our video, 15 Reasons Why You Feel Alone, for more encouragement on why being alone can actually be a great thing. Number four, you take a long time to fall asleep. You've counted the sheep, you've tensed your body and relaxed it, you've drank a glass of warm milk and you're still wide awake. Before you start having full-on anxiety attacks, rest in the knowledge that you're probably smarter than others, and that's why you can't fall asleep so easily. Your brain is too busy working through shit answering some of life's profound questions, like how is it possible that swearing is a natural pain reliever, and why did I only learn this information today? Number five, you understand why other people are the way they are. It's called empathy, ALUXers, and if you're able to put yourself inside someone else's shoes and make an effort to understand what they're going through, there's a good chance you're smarter than others. Often people base intelligence on higher IQ scores, but it's really higher EQ scores that makes a person smarter. Researchers at Texas Tech University confirmed that smarter people could recognize the feelings of others, and those people were also more willing to help others out without expecting anything in return. As author of Emotional Intelligence, Daniel Goleman puts it, "Our ability to manage ourselves and relationships, emotional intelligence, matters twice as much as IQ." If this is your first time here with us, go to ALUX.com/freebook and get Emotional Intelligence for free, thanks to the partnership with our friends at Audible. Number six, you can ignore the heart if needed. Now you're probably thinking, hold on, ALUX, you just said EQ means someone is smarter, and we did, but this is different. Let us explain. When faced with a tough or difficult decision, smarter people are able to bite the bullet and just make the decision. They don't hold on to it forever. They know it's shitty, and the sooner they make that decision, pull off the band-aid, whatever you call it, the better. They know the sooner the decision is made, the sooner things can continue, and everyone knows where they stand. Number 7. You talk to yourself a lot. You're already happy in your own company, you don't need social interactions to validate who you are, and your inner thoughts keep you awake at night. So, no surprises, you speak to yourself a lot. Psychologist researcher Gary Lupien did an experiment to put this theory to the test. He had a group of volunteers go into a grocery store with a list of what they needed to buy. The list was just verbally relayed to them, with the instruction that half the group could repeat the items that needed to be bought and the other couldn't. Those that kept repeating the items remembered them far better than those who didn't, and they could retrieve the items faster as well. He further added that speaking to yourself stimulated memory, clarified thoughts, and helped one to stay focused. Number 8. Some people find it hard to relate to you. There's a study suggesting you can only relate to people within your IQ range if you're of higher intelligence. If you have intellectual curiosity and you're trying to hang out with those that don't, it's a mismatch made in, well, not heaven, that's for sure. If you find it difficult to make friends and you've tried on numerous occasions, but it just doesn't seem to work out, it might be that you're smarter than the crowd you're trying to be friends with. It can be draining and frustrating to keep the conversation flowing because they're just not on the same level as you are. Euripides once said, "We pay a high price for intelligence. Wisdom hurts." Number 9. You have social anxiety. Hey Luxers, if you're already struggling to mix and make friends with people that are not on the same IQ range, you probably also experience social anxiety. Before you even head to an event or social gathering, you start to worry about it. We're not speaking of the extremes here, like social anxiety disorder. That's a league of its own. We're just referring to the feeling you get before you go head into any social situation. You get dry mouth, itchy throat scenario. Your palms might get sweaty and you feel like you gotta pee a lot. Your heart rate accelerates, you blush, your stomach feels terrible and you can barely breathe. Those are all signs of social anxiety, and smart people often experience some or even all of these symptoms. Number 10. You're really good with figurative language. Metaphors, similes, personification, all the colorful ways to write and speak come easily to smart people. It's not just a playful puppy, it's an exuberant, high-spirited, fun-loving puppy. Language is there to be used and enjoyed, and of course, we always leave room for expletives. Number 11. You question reality. Hey Luxers, if you've been with us for many years, you'll no doubt remember an old quote we liked, "Reality is negotiable," taken from Tim Ferriss. As he says, outside of science and law, all rules can be broken and it doesn't require being unethical. Smart people know they can choose and change their reality at any time. They question reality and push the boundaries. They question the truth. They know that two people witnessing the same car accident will report the accident differently. They each have their own version of the truth. Smart people take risks. Look at the Elon Musks, the Nikola Teslas, and the Pythagoras's of the world. And sure, there's a fine line between eccentric genius and smart madman. But they all took risks and all went ahead with their work, despite being told otherwise by those around them. Number 12. You worry a lot. Anxiety, worry, and intelligence go hand in hand. An anxious mind is busy considering all possibilities, playing out each outcome, and crossing the T's and dotting the I's. A study conducted by Israeli psychologists took 80 students and set them up with a computer. When they switched the computer on, they received a message saying the PC had a virus and they needed to get help from technical support. They set up various obstacles en route to get help, to increase their stress and anxiety levels. The students that exhibited higher levels of stress and worry during the experiment had higher IQ levels than those that didn't stress as much. It also stated that worry was linked to intelligence because worry could potentially save us from dangerous situations. Number 13. You tend to procrastinate and be messy. Hey, Luxers, if you're one of those people who can put it off until tomorrow and then tomorrow rolls by and you put it off until the next tomorrow, chances are you're pretty smart. Now, take a look at your desk or bedroom. Is it neat or messy? If it's an organized mess, basically you still know where to find your shit, then you're of higher intelligence. To further affirm this, a study conducted by the University of Minnesota claims that smart people leave their areas kind of messy because instead of investing time to clean their space, they'd rather use it for more important things. We give that study 2 thumbs up. Number 14. You know what you don't know. When you're smart, you realize you don't know everything and you don't have all the answers. You acknowledge there's always something to learn and someone to learn from, whether they're older or younger than you. You're always open to learning and won't pass a judgment until you know all the facts. The late American spiritual teacher, author, and philosopher Vernon Howard put it beautifully when he said, "Always walk through life as if you have something new to learn, and you will." Number 15. You don't post inspirational bullshit on social media. Hey Luxers, we found several articles suggesting that people who post inspirational messages and memes on social media are not as intelligent as those who don't. So we decided to look into this a bit more, and we're so glad we did, because it seems even that study was reported inaccurately and taken out of context. But it's a perfect case in point, in that smart people don't just take people's words as law. If it seems odd or unusual, they go and investigate and draw their own conclusions from the evidence presented. So go ahead and keep posting your motivational memes. There's always someone who needs to read them. So, Aluxers, what signs do you believe are telltale hints that someone is smarter? Share your thoughts with us in the comments. And since you stuck with us until the end, of course, we've got a bonus for you. Aluxers, fortunately, it's not all doom and gloom if you don't have any of these characteristics. Sure, we're all born with a certain level of intelligence, part genetics, part luck of the draw, but there's a lot you can do to increase your intelligence. Do things differently, get out of your regular routine, read a lot, and diversify your reading list. Play brain games like we mentioned earlier, get regular exercise, eat well, listen attentively, and for fuck's sakes, Aluxers, don't feel guilty when you're spewing out those swear words. It's all par for the course. Until next time, Aluxers, don't forget to subscribe and show your appreciation by clicking that like button.